It is a women's 115-pound matchup between Paige VanZant and Karolina Kowalkiewicz. She's one of the more well-rounded fighters, DC, that we have in this division. A true mixed martial artist. Her first martial art was MMA. That certainly helps.
Yes, she's a new breed of fighter. A fighter that, as a young girl, she was brought into a gym. And in that gym, she told the coaches, I don't want to wrestle. I don't want to do jiu-jitsu. I don't want to kickbox and box. I want to do it all.
Right.
Is there an MMA class for my daughter to take part in? She did that from day one, and you see all that development over the course of a lifetime has led her to the octagon, where she is already making her impact.
Yeah, she said, I didn't want to get to the UFC until I was 100% comfortable in every situation. So far, so good for her. She's got a big one in front of her here tonight. All right, so here is the UFC superstar Paige VanZant. She's about as classy as it gets. Injuries have become part of the narrative, at least recently here. She'll try to get on track here tonight.
Yes, Paige VanZant is a star, right? The magnetic personality, the big smile. She lights up every room she steps into. She's just a person that you want to be around because you know she's exuding happiness. But that's until she goes into an octagon. When she gets into an octagon, she is nasty. A fighter's fighter, a person that's willing to go out there and just let it all hang out. Even in defeat, you see the toughness of Paige VanZant.
She had a huge win by submission over Rachel Ostovich. That was January of 2019. Seems to have the arm injuries in check. We'll see how it goes for PVZ here tonight. Our tale of the day for this strawweight fight. VanZant is 26. Kowalkiewicz is 34. VanZant is 1 inch taller. The reach is identical. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 13 wins, 7 losses. She stands 5'3" tall, weigh in at 115 pounds, Karolina Kowalkiewicz. And now introducing her opponent. Fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a freestyle fighter, holding a professional record of 8 wins, 5 losses. She stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Portland, Oregon, 12-gauge Paige VanZant. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta.
You ready?
All right, so here we go with round one. You've got maybe the division's most well-rounded fighter taking on a Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioner of the highest order. You got to sprawl and brawl tonight.
Yeah, you got to sprawl and brawl. You got to keep this fight upright. She needs to make sure that she doesn't overextend on any punches and find herself on the ground grappling with this fantastic jiu-jitsu specialist.
And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands.
Big punch land. Real nice body kick land.
She almost moved right into harm's way there as the body strike lands. Can't leave your body that wide open if you want to stay in this fight.
Let it go now.
Nice looping punch.
Effective use of the jab by Kowalkiewicz.
Look at the force behind that leg kick.
And now they are throwing both sides with conviction.
Big kick lands.
Kowalkiewicz gets tagged by that straight punch. Nice land for the offense there.
Big liver kick lands under the elbow.
Oh, grab that one at all. Spinning back fist.
That one landed clean. Beautiful body.
Oh, that's a good right hand. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. The strikes continuing to pile up. 27 total strikes have now landed for Poland's Karolina Kowalczyk. Van Zandt's shot there is blocked. Kovalkiewicz's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. And there she goes, using her jab effectively yet again. Her opponent's got to raise that guard or this fight could end soon.
Well, she's going to have to do something. I think she needs to move her head off the center line because hands go up, the jab goes to the body, then the jab goes to the head. If you start worrying too much about her jab up top, she'll just start pounding that jab right through your midsection, which then will just empty the gas tank.
Kowalczyk gets caught with that punch. And there comes the separation now. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Oh, how good was that right hand? Beautiful connection by her there.
Right down the pipe and right on the chin. Beautiful body kick.
Under 2 minutes in the first round. Quick entry to get
Man,
in on a single.
That was a great single.
How good is her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Borg just transitioning so beautiful.
Yeah, she's so good at transitions and movement. Her ability is unmatched.
Ooh, uppercut lands. We'll see where she goes from here now. Big knee to the body. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Oh, that's an outstanding attempt with the kick there. Now we'll see if she can follow it up.
So fast to the target. What a great job.
And both fighters exchange in the pocket. Oh, head kick. Oh, straight right. All right, so the narrative in this one continues to be her educated jab and once again using that weapon to keep her opponent up.
She started to write the story in round one, and she has continued down the path to victory behind a beautiful jab. What a phenomenal, phenomenal boxer we are watching tonight.
Battling for hooks. Nice land there with the right punch. Easy to see why that is her weapon of choice.
Great right hand. Nice land.
Nice punch there by Van Zandt.
Liver kick.
Just out of range with that uppercut. 15 seconds. All right, so again, we find ourselves here in the clinch where there are obviously no shortage of subtleties and nuances. A lot of motions in here that maybe are lost on the casual fan.
Absolutely, and it's gonna be the underhook. For all the things that happened in position, the person winning and controlling the underhook battle is the one out ahead.
All right, the round is over, but not before she landed one of the true highlights of this calendar year, that Superman punch, and it landed flush.
Great job just allowing yourself to do whatever you are thinking in the moment, to let your mind be free. She may have practiced this before, but to try it in real-life competition is a whole different story. She did that, and it landed.
Feel me flow as not even nature.
Great punch landed with so much power. Oh, big elbow.
Just missed with the elbow there. Oh, she's really starting to put together some significant body shots here, attacking both sides now. Oh, Kovalkiewicz's lower jaw does not look good. I'm not sure it could be any more swollen. She continues to fight through it. Let's see how far she can go.
Punch over the top.
Oh, she lands a combination now. Nice volume of strikes, and it was hard to find a miss in there. She's on point.
Volume is very important, but the accuracy stands out above all in that combination.
73 total strikes have now landed for Karolina Kowalczyk. And if you care at home, the accuracy rate now, 53% against Paige Van Zandt. Combination from Van Zandt.
right under the elbow. Body kick lands.
Van Zant gets caught with that punch.
Real quick leg kick.
Oh, beautifully done there. She lands another strike to the body. Well, she went to the straight left, unable to connect. Again, they will clinch. We'll see how it goes. Lands a glancing right hand upstairs.
Another strike to the head lands.
Kovalkiewicz gets tagged by the head kick there. Not sure how many more of those she can absorb if she wants to stay in this fight.
Look at the turnover in that kick.
Superman punch.
I'm not sure her striking has ever looked better, DC, finding the range with relative ease here tonight.
She's doing a great job of timing everything. She is seeing everything out there.
Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. No hesitancy whatsoever here in round two. She has clearly found her rhythm and range. And we have passed the midpoint of the fight. She slips that left hand there.
Oh, big elbow. I mean, look at the commitment to kicking in this fight.
Rips the body there for good measure. Oh, she blocks the punch.
Big body kick.
Oh, straight to the body by Kovalkiewicz. Wow, what a kick. Connects with a right. Oh, she works the body as well as anybody in this division. Another strike there, and these shots are really gonna take their toll as this fight moves on. Effective strike there by Van Zant.
Real sneaky body.
Some nice back and forth action here. Beautiful straight punch, and now her opponent's firmly on the rope.
But she can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming. Oh, that's a nice strike.
Again, back into this position.
Kovalkiewicz gets the tie clinch here. Seconds to go in round two. Man, high volume of strikes in this round as she continues to land and pour it on. It's amazing that she has been able to maintain this aggression with her striking throughout this fight. Seconds winding down in round two.
Good stick. Sneaky head kick.
All right, round three coming up next. Anybody's fight. All right, no telestrator for the champ tonight, but that's okay. He'll still talk you through the replays. Body kicks for days, man.
I mean, body kicks for days, but I got to be honest, John. If we don't incorporate a telestrator into this game, this may be my only version of EA UFC.
All right, so here we go with our next round. Will the narrative be the same? In the previous round, it was all about her kicks, the power, the accuracy. Really a sight to behold.
I don't know why it will change. I don't think that her opponent has received the advice that she needs to make the necessary adjustments. She will go out there and start doing the same exact thing, which will in turn put her right back on the receiving end of those nasty kicks.
Oh, she continues to work the body here to great effect. Just out of range with that left hook.
What a punch.
All right, let's go. Let's get those hands going now. Calm down. It's okay. Come on. Just missing on the uppercut there. ...125 total strikes have now landed for Poland's Karolina Kowalkiewicz. And landing at a 49% clip tonight thus far against Paige VanZant. All right, so she continues to land a high number of strikes here, just like she did in the previous round. As efficient as any striker in the division, this is a world-class display of striking here tonight. And she connects with a punch there. We'll see if she can follow it up now.
She's been landing at a super high rate. She's in a great flow right now.
Man, her striking looks clean tonight. Timing on point.
Her timing on point. Her accuracy's on point.
Now she misses with the left punch there. Trying to stay in this fight.
There's no tell on that leg kick.
Oh, the right hand is there for hard shots landing on both sides here.
Ooh, what a punch.
3 minutes now to go in this one. And there's that jab again. She continues to effectively use that weapon. If it's not the best jab in this division, it's certainly close.
I feel it's the best jab in the UFC, regardless of gender. She is unbelievable at finding the target, getting back to her ready stance, and then popping the jab again. Watch for the right hand to follow very, very soon.
And she's doubling up on the jab there. All right, so she finally gets the takedown here after many failed attempts. Obviously, she was not discouraged, stayed committed. Now she has the fight in her wheelhouse on the canvas. Let's see what she can do with it. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Kowalkiewicz is back in full guard. Well, she's up, but she looks hurt. All right, getting late in the fight. This should be good. It's been all action thus far, and we will see which woman steps up.
These women have laid it all out on the line. They have sustained this pace the entire time. Who is going to be able to finish the job?
Trying to establish that jab once again. And she connects with a punch there, champ.
She's so accurate. She's so good at timing all of her strikes.
Well, how urgent is this fighter down the stretch? She is really lighting her up now. She found her range in the middle of this fight, and she is making up for lost time. Beautifully timed and placed kick there by VanZant. Both fighters exchange in the pocket here.
Nice punch there.
Oh, massive knee with a body. That can't feel good. Well, the right hand has been there for her tonight at times. Not that time. Went for the inside leg kick. Oh, an instinctive land there as she goes to the jab, DC. Nicely done.
That jab is stopping her in her tracks. It is not only a range finder, she is really damaging her opponent behind the jab.
There, DC, and now her opponent may be seeing stars at this point.
Her opponent's seeing stars. Her opponent's hurt. She has to really get after her now and try to find that kill shot that's going to finish tonight.
And she lands a punch there. We'll see if she can start to turn these singular strikes into combinations now.
She's going to have to find something to follow that big strike that she's landing over and over again.
VanZant gets hit by that kick to the mid. Whoa! Just out of range with the big right hand.
Oh, my goodness!
They go the 15-minute distance. What a fight! Official decision now in, the Buff has it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. For the winner by split decision, 12-gauge Paige VanZant.
All right, so she gets it done by split decision. We sort of thought that's what we were headed for, that the judges would be split in their opinion. Your thoughts on the decision?
Well, you saw the fight build. You saw the fight build. You saw the ebbs and flow of the fight. You didn't know who was winning. And when that happens, a lot of times, you don't know who's getting the decision, but it's so much worse for the two fighters. Because when they go to the middle and the judge grabs them,